There are no 3 o'clock buses, and all activities tomorrow are also canceled. Okay, could I now please have everybody stand and remove your hats for the Pledge of Allegiance, conducted by Student Council President Annie McDowell.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you. Please remain standing. Please remain standing. We are now going to have the Star Spangled Banner and followed by the Alma Mater. So please remain standing. Performed by our high school choir, directed by Mrs. Walter. Please remain standing for both. Coached by Jackie Blazer. JV cheerleaders, please take the floor. The Mexico High School Varsity Junior Varsity cheerleaders are continuing their work in the community this season. In December, the girls teamed up with Christmas in Mexico and served cookies and milk to children visiting Santa and Mrs. Claus. The Varsity and Junior Varsity cheerleaders will be kicking off their competition season. It would have been tomorrow, but I don't think it is anymore, at Chittenango.
Come on.
conditioning fitness teams, would you please stand up? If you are on this rank, then coach of the fitness team is Coach Morbido. This year's varsity winter weight training is a fair mixture of high school and middle school participants. The workouts have been very promising. The participants are learning and implementing the proper techniques required for productive weight training. This group works extremely well together and have been a joy to coach. Let's hear it for the strength and fitness team. Now for our hockey players and Coach Keegan. And our hockey players, please stand up. See these guys in action, but they do a heck of a job on the ice in a tough physical sport. Come out and try to watch sometime. They show a lot of heart when they play. Let's hear it for the hockey team. Next up are our varsity boys swimming and diving teams with Coach Parker, Coach Hibbert, and Coach Oliver. Stand up. The boys varsity swimming and diving team is 6-2 overall and 4-0 in the league. The Tigers have turned in some great performances already this season and have several athletes ranked in the top 10 for Section 3. The team has 5 more home meets through the end of January. Come out and support them as they look to claim the program's 3rd league title and 7th sectional title. Go Tigers! Let's hear it for the boys. Will our JV and varsity wrestlers please stand with Coach Loomis and Coach LeDuc. These guys have been working real hard this season. Keep up the effort. Varsity has a 3-2 dual meet record. Individual tourney champs this season are Austin Reed and Jaden Allen, with multiple other finalists. We will be closing the season with 3 more dual meets before the state qualifiers. Good luck, wrestlers. Let's hear it for the wrestling team. Let's hear it for our boys and girls track teams and their coaches, Mr. Mains and Mr. Charles. Will you please stand? A healthy mix of veterans and newbies. Returning superstar academic wizards are seniors Kyle Higby, Katie Belcher, Wyatt Jensen, Ashton Areola, Ty Grasso, Brandy Mains, CJ Norton, Leah Williamson, Cheyenne Trudell, and Maddie Dale Pete. Wish them luck while they run circles around the other schools at the SRC Arena. Good luck, track team. Let's hear it for the track team. Now if the JV girls basketball team and Coach Mucky would please stand. The Tigers have 3 players averaging 10 points or more and averaging nearly 40 points per game. So far this season, the team has wins over APW and Salvin. Come out and support the team as they look to improve and add more wins to their schedule next week. Let's hear it for the girls' JV basketball team. Now if the girls' varsity basketball team and Coach Anthony would please stand. The girls' varsity basketball team is led by Hannah Fravor and Eliza Deasy. All members of the team continue to get better each day as they face extremely tough opponents each game. Come out and support the girls next time they play at home. Let's hear it for the girls' basketball. Now will the JV boys basketball team and Coach Gagnon please stand at this time. The JV boys basketball team is halfway through the season and has picked up key wins against Oswego County opponents APW, Hannibal, and Oswego. We will look to increase our total in the W column as the season progresses and play at a high level the remainder of the year. The team would like to thank everyone for their support. Let's hear it for the boys JV basketball team. Now if the boys varsity basketball team and Coach Callahan would please stand. Boys varsity basketball team is working very hard this season and making progress as the year goes on. Keep up the good work. Thank you. Let's hear it for the boys basketball teams. All right, so now let's get busy with these spirit games. So let's move on to our class competitions. So I need all students that signed up for contest to come down to the table now. Contest. Go. While the students are getting organized, our first contest is going to be our lip sync contest. Each group is going to be judged on their enthusiasm and accuracy. I need some members of the faculty to please come out and serve as judges. Please come to the center of the court. All lip sync participants to the center of the floor. The sophomores will be lip-syncing to the song Frozen Lips.
Thank you.
The judges will now get together and make their decisions. From the lip sync contest, in fourth place, earning 5 points, is the sophomores. In third place, earning 10 points, is the freshmen. In second place, earning 15 points, is the senior with the next up is obstacle course, with each class having a student and a teacher volunteer to make up the team. The student's job, listen to the instructions here, the student's job is to push the teacher around the gym to each station on the scooter. Once they arrive at the station, the teacher has to get off the scooter and put on a part of the winter outfit. Boots, a sweatshirt, a coat, hat, and gloves. And then they have to race back to me to win it. The competitors for the freshman class are Dylan Marino and Mrs. Michaelis. For the sophomores, it's Avery West and Mrs. Carocchio. For the juniors, it's Rachel Rose and Carl Weiss. And for the seniors, it's Maya Deloche and Mrs. sophomores, juniors, seniors, then freshmen. Next up is our Unwrap a Present. Each student will be given a present to unwrap. The student does it in the quickest points goes to first. Second place gets 5 points. There is a catch though. You have to unwrap the present with oven mitts on and take all the paper off of the present. Our contestants are Blake Carter, Chloe LeDuc, Grace Frazier, and Ella Rose Lemay. Sophomore second. So 10 points go to the seniors, 5 points go to the sophomores. Next up, this is the game I've been waiting for. Next up is our Find the Lifesavers game. Each student participant tries to be the first to find 6 lifesavers and a mound of whipped cream. They need to stick their mouth in the whipped cream. No hands may be used to find the lifesavers. Once found, they have to spit them out onto another plate. The first person to spit out all 6 of the lifesavers. Second place is 10. Third and fourth both receive 5 points. So the freshmen get 15, the sophomores get 10, and the juniors and seniors each get five. Next up is our balloon pop. Each team member has to race to the other side of the gym and pop the balloon without using his or her hands or feet. You can only pop it getting up, so there is no popping it with your fingernails. No cheating. First place team wins 15 points for their class, second place 10 points, and third place wins 5 points. Okay, look at everybody, come back down to the same end. Everybody down to the same end. Okay, so what needs to grab a balloon. Okay, so two of you go down there and grab a balloon. Two of you stay here, sorry. Two here for a balloon, two down there and grab a balloon. So what we're going to do is, starting at this end, the first team member will run down to the other end, sit on one of the balloons that are down there, pop it. When that has been done, they then hand their gloves to the next team member, who runs down to this end and pops the balloon, then hands their gloves off to the other team member. And they run back down the other end, pop the balloon, and the last team member runs to this line to finish. And you're handing the gloves to the next person. All right, it's gonna be on go. I'm gonna say, ready, set, go, on go. Here we go, ready, set, go! You gotta have the gloves. Come on, you gotta put the gloves on. So next up is the small tasks game. So if the participants could come out here to the table, please. Who signed up for the second obstacle challenge? Who else is it? We got one from every class out here? Looks like we need a junior and we need a freshman. Okay, so here's the deal with this game. First thing each contestant has to do is they have to remove every tissue from the box, but they can only do it one at a time and they can only use one hand. The second stage of the competition is the stack of cups. They have to take one cup from the bottom of the stack and move it to the top until they get to the cup that says stop. They can only move one cup at a time. So take one from the bottom, move it to the top, and there's going to be one cup in there somewhere that says stop. When you hit that cup, then you move on to the next task. The third is the bag of M&M's task. You're going to dump out the bag of M&M's, and you're going to sort into small cups by color. It's 15 points for the class, second is 10, third is 5. So remember, one tissue at a time, one hand only. You can hold the box with the other hand, but you can't use it to pull the tissues out. Ready, set, go!
Spirit yell or spirit scream.
We're going to see who the loudest in the gym are. So I need the judges to come to the center of the court, please. Judges, come to the center. Any members, I need you. So here's the thing, listen up. When your class is up, you want to scream and yell as loud as you can. If you are not a member of that class, you want to stay quiet. Because if you're yelling or you're booing, that noise is going to carry over. So if you are not a member of that class, remain quiet. All right, so we're going to start with the freshmen. On my go. Ready, set, go!
First place, 75 points.
stick. Hang on, we gotta see who won the spirit stick. Wait, we're not dismissed yet. All right, so the winner of the spirit stick for the winter is the junior choir.